Using timer delay circuit in various tasks can be very helpful. This circuit can be used to turn on motors, lamp, and other devices. In this video, I explain a timer delay circuit for you and demonstrate how to set the delay time. There are many timer circuits available on the internet or YouTube that you can easily build and use. However, it's important to understand how this circuit works. We need to know what the components used in the circuit do and why they are placed in the circuit with a specific value. Explaining the circuit and analyzing it are essential parts of learning electronics. In all my videos, I try to explain how the circuit functions.
I will start by testing the circuit with the help of this potentiometer. We can determine the delay time. I draw the circuit on paper and describe it step by step. I put 12 volts into the circuit. After the specified time, the circuit is activated. Now, let's learn together how to build this timer delay circuit. The circuit utilizes an operational amplifier called LM4558. We can construct this circuit in three different ways. In the first method, we used a transistor and zener diode. In the second method, an op-amp IC will be employed, and in the third method, gate ICs will be utilized. The easiest way to accomplish this task is by using op-amp ICs, where we'll specifically use their comparator mode. I'll start by sketching the circuit on paper for you and explaining how the circuit operates. Then, using an oscilloscope, we'll examine the circuit and optimize it to active powerful consumers such as motors or lamp in the end. To draw the schematic diagram of the circuit, I designate one line as positive voltage and another line as 0 volts. In this circuit, a 12 volt voltage is used. We need an op-amp IC, represented as a triangle in the schematic, and I am using the LM4558 IC, which has two operational amplifiers, but will only use one. Next, I connect pin 8 and 4 to positive voltage and 0 volt respectively. The inverting and non-inverting inputs are also present here, and we'll proceed to explain the steps of building the circuit. We know that an op-amp can calculate the potential difference between its two input terminals. So, if the input voltage to the non-inverting input is higher, the op-amp output will be in high state. In this circuit, using a 12 volt input, the output voltage will be close to 12 volts. However, a portion of the voltage is consumed to power the op-amp. Now, if the input voltage to the inverting input is higher, the op-amp provides the minimum voltage at the output. In this circuit, zero voltage is indicated at the output. At this stage, we need to consider a constant voltage value for the inverting input. For this purpose, I use a resistive divider connecting the first resistor to the positive voltage line and the second resistor to 0 volt or ground. In this circuit, I use two resistors of 2.2 kilo ohms, naming the higher one R1 and the lower one R2. Now, let's consider the formula for resistive division. Given that the values of two resistors are equal, according to the resistive division's formula, the input voltage will be halved and it will be applied to the inverting input. You're likely familiar with how this formula works, but for a quick reminder, I'll explain it again for you. The output voltage, Vout, is equal to the input voltage multiplied by the resistance R2, which is the resistive connected to ground, divided by the sum of R1 and R2. Plugging in the values in the formula will have 6 volts at the output. Now, to create a delay, we need to gradually increase the voltage at the non-inverting input until it exceeds the voltage at the inverting input, activating the op-amp output. For this, we'll use a resistor and a capacitor. So, we connect the capacitor to the non-inverting input. Connect the positive side of the capacitor to the non-inverting input and the negative side to ground. I am using a 1500 microfarad capacitor. To determine the charging speed of the capacitor, we need a resistor. To specify the charging time of the capacitor, we use a potentiometer as a variable resistor. By rotating the potentiometer, we can determine the resistance level. Initially, place a constant resistor, let's say 1 kilo ohm, and then add a variable resistor or potentiometer in continuation of the same resistor. I am using a 100 kilo ohm potentiometer, but you can adjust the values as needed. In the output section, we can place anything. For now, I'll use an LED to test the circuit functionality. Towards the end of the video, we'll optimize the circuit. In the output of the op-amp, we place a 1 kilo ohm resistor to limit the current, followed by an LED with a color of your choice, to indicate that the circuit is powered. We add an LED and a resistor at the beginning of the voltage path. So, this LED is only placed here to show that the circuit has voltage. We use a 1 kilo ohm resistor and an LED in a color of your choice. The circuit is complete, but there is one thing left. The capacitor placed here, when the voltage is cut off, it still retains its charge and discharges slowly. This keeps the op-amp output active. To discharge the capacitor quickly, we use a diode. Connect the diode anode to the non-inverting input and connect the cathode directly to the input voltage. The diode number can be 1N4007. When the circuit voltage is cut off, the voltage stored in the capacitor will quickly discharge through this diode. As I mentioned earlier, building a circuit from a schematic is quite straightforward. To save time in the video, I've already constructed the circuit. Now, the circuit is ready to go. I want to measure two points using an oscilloscope. The first point is pin 3 or the non-inverting input, where the voltage should slowly rise. The second point is pin 2 or the non-inverting input, which has a constant voltage. So, in this experiment, when the voltage at pin 3 reaches the voltage at pin 2 and slightly surpasses it, the op-amp output becomes active and the LED will light up. The delay time corresponds to the time it takes for the voltage at pin 3 to reach and slightly exceed the voltage at pin 2, during which the capacitor is charged through the resistor and potentiometer. In this experiment, I use an LED, but you can use a relay or a transistor to trigger anything. And later in the video, I'll demonstrate the same for you. Now, I've connected the oscilloscope to pin 2 and 3. And I am going to apply voltage to observe the result on the oscilloscope and the output of the op-amp. I place the first probe on pin 3 and the second probe on pin 2. I connect the oscilloscope ground clip to 0 volts or ground. I apply 12 volts to the circuit. The blue line represents the voltage divided by the resistor at the inverting input of the op-amp. The yellow line gradually rising in the voltage at the non-inverting input, set by the potentiometer for charging the capacitor. This indicates that the capacitor is gradually charging. So, when the yellow line meets the blue line, meaning an increase in voltage at pin 3, the op-amp output becomes active and the LED lights up. The voltage on the blue line is at 6.8 volts, and the voltage on the yellow line is gradually increasing. By turning this knob, we can increase or decrease the charging time of the capacitor. When the yellow line meets the blue line, indicating an increase in voltage at pin 3, the op-amp output becomes active, and the LED lights up. Now, I am going to disconnect the input voltage. Pay attention to the oscilloscope to see what happens. As you can see, the yellow line representing the capacitor voltage quickly decreases. This is accomplished with the help of the diode. If we don't place the diode in this section, the capacitor will discharge slowly and the op-amp output will remain active. Now, I'll apply voltage to the circuit once again. The voltage at the non-inverting input is quickly prepared by the resistive divider, but the voltage at the non-inverting input slowly rises. Now, let's explore how to optimize the circuit for other purposes. In this circuit, we only activated an LED, which is not practical for us. So, if we want to activate a high current load, we can't use the output of the op-amp with low current. In this case, it's better to use a powerful transistor or a relay. Remove the resistor and LED from this part. And I'll explain the continuation of the circuit for you here. Connect the output of the op-amp to a resistor to reduce the current, and then connect the resistor to the base of a transistor. I'm using an NPN transistor. To use a relay, place the relay coil in the voltage pass and the collector of the transistor. To protect the transistor from high voltage spikes generated during the relay coils on and off, place a diode in reverse across the relay coil. In this circuit, since we don't have many on-off cycles, the presence of this diode is not crucial. We use a 1N4007 diode. In the circuit current is not sufficient, or if there is vibration during the on-off of the relay, place a 470 microfarad capacitor across the relay coil. This capacitor charges and discharges, creating a slight delay during the on-off of the relay. The emitter is connected to 0 volts. Now, you can connect the relay terminals to a 12 volts, or use a 220 volt AC voltage to activate powerful load. This is the whole circuit.
To become proficient in drawing circuit, draw the circuit on paper along with me. In most cases, when you look at the circuit, you learn it well. But if you pause the video, you might struggle to redraw the circuit. However, if you start drawing the circuit with me, rest assured that you can easily draw the circuit without watching the video again. Alright, now what other uses do you think we can make of this simple circuit? I appreciate it if you could write it down in the comments. Thank you for taking the time to watch the video.